Have you ever realized living right is key to right? This is now in 7 minutes.
Welcome everybody. Now in 7 minutes, my name is Austin, and it's a great pleasure to really see the way the Lord is working in our lives. And I want to bless you, and I want to tell you that God is a good God. Welcome. Today is Monday, and Friday and Monday at 7 p.m. for 7 minutes, we are always connected. Stay connected and share the word to ask people to get connected as well. Today my topic is faith versus medicines. This has been a quite elaborative and topic, and there's been a lot of debates on this topic, but I want to clear something on the basis of the word of God. So I have God's word with me today. I want to teach you that what is faith. What is faith? Faith is the substance of things hoped for, or evidence of things not seen. You know the definition, Hebrews chapter 11, that faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You and me must learn first what is faith. Let's look at medicines. Medicine, what is medicine? A substance, especially a liquid, that you take in order to cure an illness. Many Christians today have mixed faith and medicines. There are many Christians who say that if you have faith, you should not have medicines. And there are some who says that if you have medicines, then why do you need faith? I think it's a very wrong comparison. I want to encourage you and clarify this misconception. As Christians, God has given us medicines to use. We must use medicines wherever it is required and however it is required. Now, I want you to understand, I told you faith is a substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. Medicine is a substance, especially a liquid, that is used to cure illness. If you see, right from 3,500 years ago, you know, medicines were originated from plants and from trees and the bark of the trees. If you remember the bank of the willow tree, 3,500 years ago, before the Sumerians and the Egyptians used to use this particular bark to cure pain. And that has been called, it has been called aspirin. It has come from the bark of a tree and used 3,500 years ago. Who has created these plants? Who has created all of these things? It is God who created the plants. It is God who created the tree. And out of this wonderful creation, God has created healing substances. Why? So that you and me should start using them whenever it is required. You might say, but Pastor, what do you think about faith? But faith cometh from hearing, and hearing the word of God. When do I use my faith? When I see something that is impossible. I want you to know that the medicine and physicians are a part of the Bible. Ezekiel 47:12. I want to take you to Ezekiel 47:12. Can we all open our Bible to Ezekiel 47 verse 12. Thank you, Jesus. So, Ezekiel 47 verse 12 says that, hear this carefully. Ezekiel 47 verse 12 says, along the bank of the river on this side and that will grow all kinds of trees used for food. Their leaves will not wither and their fruit will not fail. They will bear fruit every month because their water flows from the sanctuary. Their fruits will be for food and their leaves for medicines. The KJV version I'm reading, it says their leaves for medicines. Did you hear, or do you hear any Christian telling that medicines is not biblical? Medicines is biblical, hence you have to use. There are a lot of Christians today in churches. When they are sick, they don't go to the doctor. But why? Physicians are the creation of God. God has given wisdom to these physicians to treat us. They have learned medicine. They have understood how to diagnose a certain issue in your body. Don't go against this principle of medicines in the Bible. I want you to know 1 Timothy 5:23. Paul talks about referring about certain things you can take for cleaning your stomach to heal your infirmities. Isaiah 38:21 talks about cake of figs that is used to heal boils, which you can recover. Where are these coming from? They are coming from plants and trees. My dear friends, this is the creation of God. And over the years, over the thousands and thousands of years, the modern century, the modern medical sciences, they have taken these substances from trees. Now, if you have a pain in your body and you want to take a temporary painkiller, it is nothing wrong. You have to take on the prescription of the doctor. Now, the doctor cannot tell you, now you go in this particular valley, there's a bark of the tree, remove the from the bark, you will get this particular substance. No, they have converted those substances into a form of medicine, a tablet or a liquid. Christians, I want to tell you, come out of this misconception. It is not correct. Christians must keep faith and medicines and understand. Do you understand when Jesus was healing diseases and infirmities, who all came to Jesus? All those people who were already sick for many years. There were some who went to doctors but could not get healed. They came to Jesus and Jesus healed them. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. If you are sick, if you have some medicines, pray for those medicines in the name of Jesus. Sanctify those medicines and have them. Don't doubt your faith. You might say, but where do we use faith? Faith is the substance of things hoped for, evident of things which you can't see. When these people brought the sick and the paralysis and the dead to Jesus, when there was no way out. There are many people I know who are suffering from some sickness and disease that has no healing. I want to tell you that Jesus can heal you. Where the medicines cannot, Jesus can heal you. Don't delay from taking care of yourself. Take care of your health. Don't delay it. God has made these things possible and available in His creation. Don't despise them. Don't go against them. Don't compare medicines and faith. That is wrong comparison. You must learn to understand, where can I apply my faith? Faith comes from hearing and hearing God's word. When do I use faith? When I see a situation that is impossible, how often can I use faith? The more you go into a situation where you need, you can't see what you need, but you're hoping for it, you need to have faith. Hallelujah. I want to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you that you speak to every child of yours who are connected and those who are going to get connected later. When they learn this topic, Lord, I pray, let them know that you have given us faith. Why? So that our faith lies in Jesus. I ask you, Lord, let not your children go against your own creation. Father, help every child of God to know that medicine is your creation, O Lord God. Let Christians don't talk like foolish people, Lord. I pray that they will learn to exercise their faith in the right things, O Lord God. I ask you, Lord, even as you heal so many diseases and infirmities, there was not a single disease and sickness that, Lord, you could not heal. Where the medicines could not heal, Lord, you have healed every single one of them. Lord, I thank you and I bless you that you will give wisdom to your children to exercise faith and not reject medicines, Lord. We give you all the glory, honor, praise. In Jesus' name, we make this prayer. Amen. Thank you very much for watching. God bless you. Spread this word to all your Christian friends and churches around the world. Let them know, people who are against medicine, Christians who are against medicines, they need to learn from the Word of God. As I gave you scriptures, there are scripturals supporting that medicines is fine. Jesus himself knew the word physicians. He knew who are physicians. He knew it very well and he respected them. God bless you all, and you take care of yourself. May the Lord continue to speak to you.